Hello boys and girls, welcome to Peek Over My Shoulder in Oblivion Lost. And I accidentally hit reload instead of record. It happens. Also, I remember to close down the game and load it up again. I got rid of the controller noise. That's a little victory. But anyway, I am moving around a little bit, checking for the gas. And then I'm going to check the wishgranter part. Also, I'm going to check the possibility of infiltrating the wishgranter without the whole mission activating part. Yes, I'm still kind of... Hello! Don't you want me? Nothing can go wrong. Just accept it. Ah, I got better loot this up. Wait, did I get the ghost gun thing? Ooh, I did. Awesome. Okay. So yeah, these metal crates have random loot at. Better do that than other times. Okay, before I enter that part, I'm going to make a manual save. Save. Lava! The floor is lava! It automatically passes once you find the lava. I know it doesn't make any sense, you poor people, but please, shut up. Also, if you think that I'm going to jump through the teleporter, you're sorely mistaken. Another thing that I'm wondering about is how come I had the wishgranter mission to anyway? Okay, I guess that's oh. Well, it appears that these voices don't respond to the audio, other audio settings of hers. Bummer. It's very cool and immersive, but after a while it does get a little bit too much, especially since they are so loud and especially since you can't tweak the voice over now.
Play the game. Are removed in preparation for the test. Because this time in the Soviet Union, any information about the risks of nuclear power was classified. As far as these men know, Soviet reactors are flawless. Nothing ever goes wrong. Nothing can go wrong.
Oh, I think lowering the music volume actually did. Is a little bit quieter. So yes, let's play a game. Point one, the floor is lava. Point two, I want to get around without the teleporters. Sort of check out how far I can get without doing the teleporters. So I turned down the effects. Seems to take care quite a bit. Let's see. Don't step into the campfire. I wonder if it was possible to get to the roof. Get to the roof from here as well or not. going to attempt a little wee bit for an ancient scroll. Okay, pixel. Whoops. Again. Okay, right position, wrong living condition, I guess. Again. So I have increased my impact tolerance also. Sausage! One thing with this chance is to see that you're not bumping your head into something. Oh, come on! It was perfect! Okay, I'm gonna try again. Come on! Oh, this just done. Also, I should probably be able to do the jump without the rocket anyway. Okay, let's try some more. So, I should actually be able to reach that beam without the rocket. Oops. Too bad I don't have any RGD grenades, because those are very good for normal. Well, not normal, but non-launcher grenade assisted jumps. Did you stop? You were supposed to be jumping. Check out this corner while I'm here. Hello, we have viewers, I believe. Bodies over there. Is that the display that I made before, or is that something else? I'm gonna attempt it with the different grenade, which I'm going to try a little bit farther around. Oh, it's too far. And this is the last one. Well, it worked, I guess, but again, for one condition on the player being live. Okay, I am going to try this without recording from now on. And I will start recording once I'm on that ledge. It almost worked. Oh, I didn't need a grenade jump, I just sort of hopped on the beam here. Well, okay. So much about all that experimenting. Also, I seem to remember that there were monolith fighting in these levels. But in any case, I am going to make a manual save here, and I'm going to celebrate by ending the episode and dedicating a new one entirely again for exploring the inside of this structure. So, thank you for watching, and see you soon.